1Password 7 is agile, but it's the latest version of 1Password for Mac and brings a ton of welcome changes and security improvements. If you can get around the fact that it now requires a monthly subscription, this may be worth checking out. In this video, we're not going to go super in-depth on the app and what it does, but if you want to learn more about it, check out our review on 1Password 6 that we made a few years ago. Opening up the app, we will find a lot of similar things that we know and love with the old version of 1Password. We're presented with all of our passwords in the rich, beautiful icons, links to the websites, one-time password, usernames, notes, and everything else you'd need. The sidebar is where a lot of the changes take place. We can still sort through all the types of saved items, such as credit cards, addresses, and much more. We can also tag items and organize them into certain categories, but new and one of my favorite changes is the password security section. In this section, we can check for possible security breaches, leaked passwords, unsecure sites, reused passwords, and much more. At the top of each login item in the main view, we will also see a banner at the top saying that there is a certain issue and you may want to change your password. They've also made quite a few changes to the menu bar applet and plugin within browsers. Now we have a whole window that opens and presents much more information than the previous version. It's also much easier to search through your logins and generate a new password. So this is a super great update, and what do you do if you want this new version? Well, unlike previous versions, this one is available for free from the App Store. While it's nice that you no longer have to pay through the App Store, it means that you'll need a monthly subscription. They still do offer a single device license, but with this version, you'll most likely need the monthly plan. Pricing starts at $3 per month when you pay for the year, and they have many plans available, but it's something to note that this is a paid upgrade and will likely end up paying monthly for it. If you don't use the app on the monthly plan, you can still sync everything to iCloud and Dropbox. However, use the subscription, everything's now located on the 1Password servers. While I do like iCloud Sync and my testing, 1Password Sync service is very reliable, and I had no issues creating passwords on my Mac and finding them right away on my iPhone. Just note that if you want to use the app within a single device license, you'll need to download the version from their website, not the App Store. Overall, I'm a big fan of the app. I love the new look, and the added security tab is a nice place to check on the status and safety of your accounts. Once again, the app is available for free from the App Store, and with the monthly subscription, you can also get it on iPhone, Android, and Windows for free. Links to everything will be down below. If you have any questions about the app, let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, leave a like and hit the subscribe button for more videos like this. This is Mark with iAppleTech1Toit, and I'll see you in the next one.